Welcome. My name's Monty. I'm coming from North Carolina. Right now, it is raining outside and chilly. It's in the 30s and raining. It sleeted and snowed a little last night. Some parts of the mountains got a good bit of snow. Where we are, we just got rain. But what I wanted to do today was to talk about gardening. As I'm sitting there talking about places it snowed last night, and then I'm talking about gardening in the same sentence, that kind of seems kind of strange in a way. That's a warm weather thing, right? Well, actually, no. So there's two things right now that I'll argue that you should be doing. One is that if your ground isn't snow covered and it's not frozen, then I think now is a really great time to be improving your soil. And the other thing we'll circle back to is to start plants indoors. It's that time to do that. Now, if you don't have seeds yet, then you really need to get on that because you're way behind the eight ball. And there's some delays this year in getting a lot of popular seeds because I think a lot of people are going to do a garden, especially being home with the COVID thing and the uncertainties about the supply chains, especially when it comes to food. Gardening is top of mind now with a lot of people. So let's kind of dive in. Let's talk about soil. So when you think about soil, everybody says, well, it's no big deal. I'll add some fertilizer. But adding fertilizer is only part of the equation. See, there's this whole ecosystem besides your plants. If all we're thinking about is growing plants in dirt, then we're missing out on a big chunk of the picture. If you look up regenerative soil, you'll find all kind of information about how to build better soil. So soil is comprised of dirt and minerals and water when it rains and moisture when it's not raining. But it's also comprised of this ecosystem that we don't see. And so what we don't see is all the little critters that live in the soil, from the size of bacterium on up. There's insects, there's worms, there's spores, like mushroom-type, fungal-type things. There's bacteria, and those are all part of your soil. Now, why does that matter? Well, that matters because your plants are going to use what's in the soil to produce good stuff for you. And if it's missing minerals and trace elements and other things, or it's not healthy, your plants won't produce as well. And the fruit they give you, while it might look healthy, it's not as healthy as it could be because the plants are having to make do with what they have. So if you can improve your soil, you can improve the quality of your food and how healthy that food is. There's a lot of discussion now about how any crop 50 years ago or 100 years ago was actually healthier for you because it included a lot of stuff that's missing now. And then, of course, we have stuff we've added in terms of pesticides, insecticides, so forth. But so improving your soil is an important thing to do right now. You've got like 3 months before you start to start growing stuff in there. So now's the time. You've still got time to get organic matter started in your soil. It's probably too late to start a cover crop, but you get this organic matter mixed in, which helps all those other things grow. And then in the fall, if you're not going to have a winter garden in that garden space, then start your cover crop. But so things you can do right now are bring in wood chips, which is really kind of getting late in the game for the wood chips because it takes a while to break down. And the same for straw, but you can still add it. And then also compost. Now would be a great time to mix in composted material into your garden and then maybe put wood chips on top of that. What that does is that helps your soil be a fertile ground for not only the plants, but all the stuff that lives around the roots of the plants. Remember, the plants have roots, and these roots are very, very delicate and tiny structures. And these roots have to pull nutrients, water, and so forth out of the ground and be in contact with the ground. Well, how those roots work, that whole process, is part of a greater ecosystem. Now, there's a no-till-till argument, and it's beyond the scope of this discussion, but what you want to do, though, is you want to build the quality of your soil, which means you've got to build the entire ecosystem. So start now. You know, get that compost. If you're going to add manure, add it now. You're running out of time because you really want any hot manure that's not composted, to have 90 days before you pull any food out of the garden so you're not actually accidentally pulling manure with your food. These are things you need to be doing right now. Like I said, if you look up regenerative soil, there's tons of information on that. The permaculture people, the no-till people, the organic people. And don't feel like you have to go organic with your soil. Organic is a very defined way of farming. Organic probably doesn't mean what you think it does. So I would suggest, instead of trying to be organic in your farming at this point, that you look at regenerative practices. And those regenerative practices, you can turn into organic later, but that's kind of the building block. So the organic, look into it. Don't just take my word, but I think regenerative is something to think about. And then also, too, do some reading on permaculture and how that applies to your garden. And it's probably at this point, the permaculture approach may be something longer term. It's going to take a while to put in place, but it's definitely good to understand. But the regenerative soil practices are great to understand, and that's something you can start on now. And it benefits you whether or not you go organic, if you have a permaculture type approach later. Building good soil is the building block of it all. So if you're going to start from seeds, then what you'll want to do is to make sure to have the seeds you need. And I'd suggest, if you don't have them, you need to be ordering them really quick, because there's a lot of demand on seed producers this year. We buy a lot from southernexposure.com, and that's a great place to get your seeds. Southernexposure.com is a seed company that's a few hundred miles away from us, but we've got really good results from their seed. I have no financial interest in that company. They've never provided anything free or anything like that. I'm a happy customer. Need to get your seed ordered? Figure out what you're going to put in your garden. I would suggest doing that this week, no later. Some of these seeds are going to get to be hard to find. Like I said, there's a lot more gardening going on this year than there has been in a long, long time. So these companies started happening last year. They were just slammed with orders, and that's kind of happening again too. So then the next thing you'll want to do is to have some potting soil. You can make your own or you can buy it. And potting soil is a soil that you just use to start your seeds. It really doesn't have a huge amount of nutrients, and it's not a long-term thing for the plant to live in. The idea is that as your seeds come up and you start growing into a plant, that plant's big enough to transplant outside when you're past your last frost date. But now's the time to get those going, because it takes a few weeks to get those plants up and going. If you have a mishap, it gives you an opportunity to kind of start over. There's a lot of ways to start seeds. You can buy these seed starting kits. You can make your own. There's a bunch of different ways. You can be YouTube certified on this in a few minutes. And so I'd suggest doing the research, watch the videos, YouTube, Rumble, what have you, and then start your seeds and get those started. And that way you'll be ahead of the game when you've worked on your soil for these 3 months coming up. February, March, and April, and then you've got your plants going. And so now, when it comes time, be the last frost date, the last hard frost that's expected, you can get those plants in the ground and get a head start and start getting food out of your garden earlier. And that is my suggestion for this week. Kind of that, what are we doing here? We've been working hard on that here. We started working on building better soil about a year and a half ago, and then we've got a cover crop now. And I have my chickens, my ducks, and my geese are working hard in the garden to terminate that cover crop for me. The way they're terminating the cover crop is they eat it, and then they scratch in the garden space and turn that top layer of soil over. Now, if you're thinking, doesn't that destroy all the microbes that I was just talking about building? Well, the good thing with chickens and ducks and geese, they tend to not destroy it like it would if you tilled it. So if you tilled it, you a lot of that is just gone. It has to start over. But with the chickens and the ducks and the geese, they don't scratch as deep usually. Maybe in some spots they do, but for the most part, they just turn it. And so it's good. It introduces oxygen a little lower down, introduces some nutrients. They're adding it nutrients because they're pooping in there. And then they're scratching and they're moving in there. So it's a fairly gentle, compared to tilling, way of improving your soil. And so this is a great way to do it. If you have chickens, get those chickens out in that garden, and they'll help with that. I hope this is helpful. I'm definitely interested in your comments and thoughts. Please don't hesitate to email me or leave a comment. Thanks for listening and have a wonderful day.